rail. There's a lot of rail operators in Australia who already have plans underway and are just waiting to make some announcements about fuel cell rail. The nice thing about this, when you convert a rolling stock to a hydrogen fuel cell with a battery buffer, you don't have to build the overhead containers. So the civil cost and the actual capital cost of putting in a new line is actually much less, and that's really where the economics work in favour of the fuel cell and the fuel cell trains. And also that's happening in mining as well. And of course we'll start seeing larger open water marine projects off the coast of Australia as well. So what's happening in that, that mobility space at the heavy end of trains and marine applications? On farm, I guess it's exciting. As part of QUT, we have a research facility, the Department of Agriculture and Fisheries at Redden Bay, south of Brisbane. We're starting to work with electric tractors, so that's our first tackle on diesel, looking at battery electric tractor at a smaller scale and quite often autonomous, which is interesting. But also, when I was at the Tokyo field, I met some of the people involved in hydrogen gas injection in internal combustion engines, Westport out of Canada. So they're doing 95% hydrogen gas injection into an existing internal combustion engine. So people aren't stupid, we don't want to throw the baby out of the bathwater. If I can do a conversion kit like I did years ago at Melbourne Engineering, we're actually 95% hydrogen gas produced on farm with a local council wastewater treatment plant, I can run that asset into the ground and then look at battery electric and or fuel cell battery electric at the time when that asset's used its useful life. The good thing now, the EU is putting bucket loads of money into the European tractor manufacturers, and it's almost like a war situation. It means they've got such a bad situation there with the emissions. They're tackling that, so there's a lot of money being thrown. JCB owns 10% of their company of ITM, so basically a lot of work going on in that earth moving equipment and also tractors and fuel cells, thanks to the European government. So watch this space as well. So that's mobility. Again, energy storage, I guess the other thing.